student, today we are going to discuss about irregular adjectives and order of adjectives. So let's proceed.
Before starting the topic irregular adjectives and order of adjectives, let us do the quick revision of the introduction of adjectives. So, an adjective is what modifies nouns or nouns and pronouns in a sentence. It points out quality, size, shape, duration, and more about a noun or pronoun. There are three forms of adjectives, that is regular, comparative, and superlative. The irregular form describes one noun. For example, Jemmy is a beautiful girl, where beautiful is regular adjective, where no comparison is going on. Second is comparative degree, which compares two noun. For example, Jemmy is more beautiful than Ashley. So in this sentence, two girls are being compared to each other. The third is superlative form, which compares more than two things. For example, Jemmy is the most beautiful girl in the town. So in this sentence, Jemmy is being compared to every girl in the town. Let's see some regular, comparative, and superlative form of adjectives. Old, older, oldest. Great, greater, greatest. Big, bigger, biggest. Successful, more successful, most successful. So, the usual way to change an adjective to its comparative form is easy. We just add es, er, or the word more with the adjectives. The way to change an adjective is its superlative form is also pretty easy. We just add est or the word most with the adjectives. Now we will learn about irregular adjectives. Irregular adjectives are adjectives that do not change form by adding er or est or more or most. They do not obey the typical rules when their forms are changed. So adjectives that completely change their form in the comparative and superlative degrees are called irregular adjectives. So as we mentioned before, some adjectives do not follow the standard pattern when they are changed from one form to another. We call these adjectives as irregular adjectives. Irregular adjectives go through more radical changes when their forms are being changed. So, here is a list of irregular adjectives. Good, better, best. Bad, worse, worst. Much, many, more, most. Little, less, least. Old, elder, eldest. Far, farther, farthest. Or far, further, furthest. Now we will learn about the order in which adjectives are placed. But first of all, let's check about the things to which adjective describes. Adjectives are words that describe the color, number, size, quality of a noun and pronoun that qualifies. They also used to compare two or more people, animal, place or things. For example, 5 juicy yellow mangoes are kept on the table. My dad gifted me a big brown teddy bear on my birthday. This is an old, beautiful wooden armchair. So as you can see that in all these sentences, there can be more than one adjective in a sentence. So in this case, we need to place the adjective in an order. So let's see the order in which the adjectives are placed. The first one is adjective of number. Second is adjective of size. Third one is adjective of age. Fourth one is adjective of shape or quality. Fifth one is adjective of color. And the sixth one is adjective of material. For example, I love that beautiful old big green antique car that always parked at the end of the street. So in this sentence, beautiful, old, big, green are adjectives which are placed in the same order which we have studied right now. Like beautiful indicate the quality, old indicate the age, big indicate the size and green indicate the color. Same as the second example, my sister has a beautiful tan and white bulldog. Here big indicates the size, beautiful indicates the quality. Tan indicates the color and white also indicates the colors. So we should always remember that when there are two or more adjectives of the same group, a comma is used and the word and is placed between the last two adjectives. A comma is never placed between an adjective and noun. Let's see the example over here. The road is narrow, winding and dangerous, and the second one is the house is green and red. So the here narrow, winding and dangerous are adjective, so a comma is used between narrow and winding, and is added between the last two adjectives, which we can see in both of the examples.
So I hope you have understood the chapter. So students, keep learning and stay safe. Thank you.